I'm Dr. Eleanor Martin, Assistant Professor at the University of Oklahoma's School of Meteorology. And today, I'll be discussing the basics of energy and heat transfer. Energy is a property of objects that can come in many forms, such as the kinetic energy of a moving object, the elastic energy of a stretched solid, and the thermal energy generated by an object's internal temperature. Energy can be converted between forms, but cannot be created or destroyed. Energy can transfer via non-physical pathways called heat. Today, I will describe the four pathways along which heat can be transferred. The first pathway is conduction, a transfer of heat by direct contact between two solid objects of different temperatures. As the two objects stay in contact, the temperature of the hotter object falls and the temperature of the cooler object rises as heat passes between them. An example of this is the transfer of heat into the handle of a boiling pot. If enough energy is conducted into the handle, it will eventually get too hot to touch. The surface of the Earth can also conduct heat in the same manner. After a very hot day, a black asphalt parking lot will quickly conduct heat into the feet of a barefoot person. The second pathway is convection, a transfer of heat by the movement of liquids or gases. An example of this is the transfer of heat through boiling water in a pot on the stove. As the water near the heat source increases in temperature, it moves into cooler areas and exchanges heat with the cooler water. This same process can occur in air masses over the Earth's surface and is a major driver in the formation of clouds and thunderstorms. As moist air near the surface warms, it moves vertically in the atmosphere into cooler areas. As the air cools, the moisture condenses and creates a cloud or a thunderstorm. The third pathway is radiation, a transfer of heat by waves of electromagnetic energy, such as visible light or ultraviolet or infrared waves. If you've ever stood in front of a fire or a hot stove and you felt warmer, then you've felt radiation. Objects with hotter temperatures give off radiation in shorter wavelengths and emit more energy. Every single object with a temperature emits radiation. Our sun primarily gives off shortwave radiation, while the Earth primarily gives off longwave radiation. Radiation from our sun reaches the Earth's surface, providing the planet with the heat and energy necessary to sustain life. The fourth and final pathway is latent heat flux, a transfer of heat that occurs when an object changes phase between solid, liquid, or gas. As water in a pot is heated, all of the liquid water eventually reaches the boiling point, or the highest temperature that water can be in solid form. As the pot is continually heated past the boiling point, some of the liquid water turns into water in gas form, also known as steam or water vapor. That's why the air above the pot feels moist to the touch. Latent heat flux is often observed on the Earth's surface as evaporation from wet soils or water bodies like the ocean, and transpiration from plants. Since liquid water requires heat and energy to convert to gaseous water vapor, evaporation and transpiration result in a slight cooling of the Earth's surface. Understanding these four pathways of heat transfer, conduction, convection, radiation, and latent heat flux, is an important building block to understanding how energy and heat are transferred around the Earth.